Most of the presidential candidates here in the United States would be better off if they would learn this one vital skill. That's right, this one vital skill that you should seek to put into your life and business, and they should seek to put in their life and the business and the job they seek to obtain, a very important job. Though I'm not very optimistic, but I'd like to believe that perhaps I could do that. And today on the Christian Entrepreneur Network, on the Master Entrepreneur, I'd like to talk to you very briefly after this interlude about that vital skill for you. The program begins right now. Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and as I often say, if that doesn't describe you, if it's not a description, hopefully it is an aspiration. Greeting, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, I'm very old school. I think that being a lady or being a gentleman would be something very, very nice for you and your business, and perhaps that's one of the skills that we should all seek to learn. Perhaps for the first time, or maybe once again. My name is Stan Houston, and I've been away for about a week because two things. First of all, I have been incredibly busy helping people do exactly what I'm doing, and you should be doing too. Helping people develop their own iPod radio broadcast, their own podcast for their business. And that work has really blossomed as more and more people are getting smart and discovering that they need to learn to be on the radio if they're going to have a successful business in the near, right now, and in the future. We'll tell you a little bit more about that. Yes, I've been teaching podcasting and making videos about podcasting, and I'd be happy to share them with you. So if you want to reach out to us at radioedge77@gmail.com, radioedge77@gmail.com, I would be happy to start the conversation that will lead, I believe, to one of the more significant things you could do to build your business. Remember, 2020... we're into the second month already, and all of those good resolutions and intentions, they're falling on the wayside. Don't let that happen to you. Be one of the 3% of the population who knows who they are, what they are called to do, what their goals are, what their purpose and direction is, and they're making sure that 2020 will be a very different year in their life and in their family, in their community, and in their business. We'd like to help you. Again, tcenglobal.org/contribute now. I would be grateful if you would help us out. The Christian Entrepreneur Network is a 501c3. This comes to you tax and fee free. But if you could help us by sponsoring some of the work we do, and we could work and help you together, we would be grateful for that opportunity. Here we go. I just recently put out a description of a partner that I would like to bring into the business with me, particularly in the What It Takes radio field, in the podcasting field. And here's what I said. I want somebody who is full spirit force. Did you get that? Full spirit force. I want them to be sparking on fire. Sparking on fire. And I want them to seek to be fully alive. That is the description of the person I would like to bring into the work and the world we're doing, which we think will make a difference. If perhaps that describes you, and you'd like to reach the world and be a part of the podcasting phenomenon and part of the teaching and training and moving people ahead in their lives as a member of the Christian Entrepreneur Network, we'd like to visit with you. Think about it. As I often say, just let it sit on your head for a while and see where it moves you. Hey, now here we go. What is that one skill that every one of the presidential candidates would probably be good, and some of them would really be better off if they would do this? What is the skill they need to know? That's what the program's going to be about. Take a few minutes, take a few seconds, and think about that. What do you think it might be? And I'll go back and come back and tell you what I think it should be. I'm Stan Houston. This is the Master Entrepreneur. Another reason that I haven't been on the radio is there's been just way too much noise out there. And I don't want to contribute to stupid stuff and to stupid noise. The past week in the United States, first of all, there was all of the hectoring confusion about a vote in the state of Iowa that became a disaster, showing that people who want to run our country, they might not even be able to run a simple election. Obviously, I reflected on the fact that we were going through the State of the Union by President Donald Trump, and then the next following day, the attempt to impeach him and remove him from office failed, and that was big, big news. And, of course, along with that, there are the deep fears about the coronavirus and how that is spreading. There was just way too much going on, too much noise, too many things that are truly important that were taking the hearts, minds, and spirit of my listeners, and I was not going to contribute to the confusion. So that's one of the reasons I wasn't on the radio. But here I'm back, and I'd like to make this few minutes helpful and valuable for you. Here's what I pointed out in the program that was now almost a week ago. Here's what we said. I took off on one of my friends and colleagues, not a personal one, but I've had a conversation with him on an occasion or two. His name is Seth Godin, and he's one of the guys who is really good at putting out a lot of wisdom, insight, and truth into the business marketplace. And he put together a program for this year called Real Skills. What are some of the real skills that you're going to need? And I had a takeoff on that, and he had a whole long list of these real skills. And that brought me to think about, as a Christian entrepreneur, what are the seven skills that we should seek to obtain, to improve upon, to highlight as a part of our life as Christian entrepreneurs? And here's what I came up with. There are seven of them. First of all, we've got to learn how to pray. Praying is vital to your life and business success, and you've probably heard something similar, but this year you're going to hear, at least from me, something new about how just important praying is. And praying isn't just talking to God. Actually, it's, for the most part, doing what I did last week, just shutting up and being still and listening. Praying is a vital skill. You're going to have to become a broadcaster. Broadcasting, using the video and the audio and the media of broadcasting, you're going to have to learn how to do that to be successful in the coming era of how we market and how we do business. So you're going to have to learn some broadcasting skills. You're going to have to be a master storyteller. The only effective means of communication is storytelling, and you're going to have to learn how to do that. You're going to have to gain an appreciation of designing. Now, I love and I know the importance of design. And someone once said, Steve Jobs, his primary contribution was not in the technology of building the computer. Lots of people had that and knew that. But what made Apple different was Steve Jobs' understanding of design. And you're going to have to become a little bit more of a student of designing and understanding how it works and simply being open to learning about it. I'm not a good designer. I'm not talented. But I have surrounded myself with friends and colleagues who know how to do that, and they know how to do it well. So hopefully I will become better at designing. Sleeping. That's right, sleeping. More and more, we are discovering that most people don't get enough sleep. Learning how to sleep well, to know the life disciplines, perhaps even some of the foods and exercises and things you should do to get between 6 to 8 hours of sleep. The art of sleeping well will be vital in the future that's before us. You're going to have to be risking something. Right now, I'm dealing with a friend who I'm afraid unless they start to move out of their careful zone. You've heard of the comfort zone? Well, most people don't have comfort zones. They have careful zones. They're just things. They're going to be careful about this. You're going to have to be more involved in risking and moving when you don't know for sure what to do. Risking. If you're a Christian, you've probably heard the term faith. Faith is risking, and it's risking big time. So you're going to have to learn how to be a better, bigger, more risking taker. And then, as I said, the final things, you're going to have to learn how to say some things. Here are some skills in saying that I kind of emptied with and finished with. Thank you. I cannot believe how seldom people say thank you. Just do that. My goodness. Remember the story about what you learned in kindergarten? Learn how to say, I am grateful. Also, learn how to say, how can I help you? Again, I have a friend who tells me, and he's been very successful in his business. And he says, I was just a simple farm boy, and I wasn't extremely well educated, but I learned how to help people, and I would always say, how can I help you? Even though it had nothing to do with the business or the services I gave. I simply said, how can I help you? And I listened to them, and if I could, I helped them. How can I help you? And now I'm going to add one more to that, all right? There is one more thing you need to know, and this is something that the presidential candidates need to say. Very simply, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. How often do you say that? To your spouse, to your children, to your colleagues? The world is full of people who always have an answer, or think they do. I'm beginning to understand that successful people are those who have got the self-confidence and the spirit force to know, here's the truth. There's a million billion things that you don't know in the universe than things that you do. And part of the skill of living well is to live somewhat comfortably in the art and place and space of unknowing. A lot of us who follow the Christian faith, we're continually trying to know more. Sometimes what God would like us to do is just simply be quiet and be still and understand there are just a lot of things about life and business and the experience of God that you don't know and will not know and cannot know. By the way, any being that we can know everything about would not be God. There's far, far more we don't know about our faith, our life, our business than we do know. I'm discovering, and it was an interesting story, and always storytelling. A mentor friend shared this. He said, I'd even forgot that I said it, but 30 years ago when I was pastoring this church, this man came to me, and he asked for some help, and I gave him some advice. 30 years later, he showed up again, and he thanked me profoundly and told me that the advice I had given him some 30 years ago had been life-changing. He said, I was going through a deep time of difficulty, and your advice was, oftentimes I should just simply say, I don't know. He said, I want you to know that my marriage, my family, the life I've lived, the business I have built, has been good, in some cases very good, and it's because you taught me. And I said often, I just don't know. Didn't try to pretend I did, didn't try to give advice, or try to give counsel where I didn't know what I was doing. And by the way, there was a deep respect that people seemed to have in me and a deeper trust when I just simply said, well, I just don't know. Maybe we should try and find out. How can I help you in some other way? I don't know. One of the skills I hope to cultivate and be better at, and I think our presidential candidates would do better to remember, sometimes you just need to say, the world is difficult. Life is difficult. Things are very, very confusing. And right now, I don't know. One of the skills we need to have is to be able to stay and say and live in the not knowing. I'm Stan Houston. This is the Master Entrepreneur. And I hope this presentation has been helpful. I do know one thing. A good podcast should be less than 20 minutes, and that's exactly where we're at. I also know this, that if you take 20 minutes every day to learn something new, something you didn't know, something that would be helpful and useful, that will go very well for you in life and business. So perhaps this will qualify as a bit of your 20 minutes of learning something you didn't know, and it might be useful and practical and helpful. We'd appreciate you being useful and practical and helpful to us. That's right, tcenglobal.org/contribute now, tcenglobal.org/contribute now. And we'd love to have some of your wisdom, insight, and truth on our radio program. And we'd like to help you put your own worldwide radio program together. We can do that. That's what we do, and we do it well. All the best and blessings to you. Bye for now.